Okay, Shreyansh, so I think we can proceed ahead with your mock interview for, I think, IOCL you are going for, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, great. So, Shreyansh, we want a very brief introduction from your side first.
So, I am Shreyansh Somavarshi, final year chemical engineering undergraduate from Indian Institute of Petroleum and Energy, Vishakhapatnam. So, I belong to Prayagraj district of Uttar Pradesh. My father is an engineer and mother is a housewife. So, due to my father's nature of job, which is quite transferable, I have lived across all over India, including Jharkhand, Madhya Pradesh, Odisha, and currently I am living in Kurnool district of Andhra Pradesh. Mm-hmm. And coming to the academics, I have done my summer training in the virtual mode via in the field of petroleum refinery engineering which was conducted by ISHE. My BTEC project was the surface modification of polymeric membrane for the improvement of permeability. And along with that, I have also worked with a startup as a subject matter expert for 2 years, almost 2 years, 22 months to be precise. Mm-hmm. And coming to my extracurriculars, so I have been a part of my football, integral part of my football team since my first year, as my college was established in 2016. So I was one of the founder member, and I was also the captain of my batch football team for all the sports meet and external meets also. And in 2020, I joined the ISHE IIP student chapter as a treasurer, and we conducted 3 events. So one of the most important one was the Article Quest, which was basically a review paper writing competition. So we can develop some research analogy in the students. So coming to my strengths, so my main strengths are effective time management, leadership skills, and punctuality. And my main weakness is I tend to be lazy towards some particular kind of thing, especially the programming, which have resulted me in slightly lower CGPA than it could have been. Thank you.
Don't you think time management and laziness are, totally opposite? A lazy person cannot be very good in time management.
Yes, sir. But if he wants to do something, then it is quite possible, sir. Along with that, I didn't take any POR during my second and third years, as I was already doing an intern with that prepdoor.com as a subject matter expert. So I already had tight schedules and deadlines in my second and third year only. So somehow I managed it with my academic, and I also had my football training on the daily basis, except Sunday.
So Shreyans, let me ask you, what do you know about IOCL?
So IOCL was formed in 1964 when certain companies merged, and now it operates 9 refineries of its own and 2 subsidiary refineries, CPCL Chennai and Nariharan. And along with that, currently it is also going in other fields such as petrochemical, and recently it forms a pact with Israeli startup Finergy, making IOCL Finergy joint venture producing aluminium air battery for electric vehicles.
Okay, so tell me some competitors of IOCL and the names of competitors and how it is different from them.
So major competitor is HPCL, and along with Reliance Industries Limited, so famous for its Jamnagar refinery. So HPCL is more like corporate kind of thing, as they already came for my campus placement, a very random schedule, not focusing on technical things. So they want people to be more fluent in that communication kind of thing. And IOCL rather seeks more technical candidates as compared to HPCL.
Okay. So Shreyans, why you think you should be part of this organization? Can you tell me some of the personality traits you have which makes you eligible to be part of this organization?
Actually, one of the major traits is, sir, I also have good communication skill along with the technical skills. I done my first internship in petroleum refinery engineering, then followed by an elective in same topic through my coursework, and got recommended from my professor, who is an associate professor at IIT Kharagpur, Professor Bhaskar Baduri. And along with that, it is one of the best place to be work with and a dream start for a fresher.
Okay, so have you heard about the privatization policy of the government related to public sectors?
yes sir, they are going to do, but IOCL, which boasts of more than 20,000 employees, so I think it is very difficult. And recently Dharmendra Pradhan told that it is not possible to privatize ONGC, so I think that same goes for IOCL also.
Not entire organization, but maybe some part like piping division or something like HPCL is doing.
Sir, I don't think HPCL is already under ONGC.
But piping division of HPCL is being privatized. Are you aware?
No, sir.
So some part of public sector can be privatized.
Sir, I recently heard about that RIN, but okay. I don't think any outcome came of that also.
Okay. So if you join IOCL, Sriyansh, tell me how you will contribute.
Sir, first of all, my contribution, first contribution, that I would like to learn more about this field. So it will take a year or two for me to contribute to some extent, mm-hmm. using my knowledge, and I am good at analytical and logical skills also.
Mm-hmm.
So, but I would like to learn first before contributing anything.
Okay. So, Sriyansh, is your final BTEC project related somewhere to the profile you're going to join?
Sir, actually it's not, but if you want to relate it, there is a certain problem, that refinery wastewater treatment.
Mm-hmm.
So the first part is that oil water separation. So
mm-hmm.
if we can use the permeability of the membrane to increase the flux rate, so it can tend to higher separation of the oil water. So I did one presentation on this oil water separation using ultrafiltration module.
Mm-hmm.
So there it could have been 95% separation, but according to our thing, it could go up to 98% to 99%.
Okay. Over to you, Vishal sir.
Okay. Sriyansh, if I'll ask, start with very simple question. Can you tell us the difference between energy, 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 exergy, and energy, ANERGY? You heard about somewhere?
No,
energy,
sir.
Exergy.
I know about energy though.
Like in thermodynamics you studied?
Sir, my thermodynamics more towards solution thermodynamics.
Solution thermodynamics. So you have not studied about energy?
Sir, energy I know it is. How can I define it?
Okay.
So it is little confusing, but exergy and energy I never heard.
You have not heard about energy and exergy?
Yes, sir.
Fine. What is the difference between calorific value and energy?
Sir, calorific value is some kind of how much energy a fuel will release.
Mm-hmm.
So that is the calorific value.
Mm-hmm.
So it is given by, I think, per mole of the fuel, per mole or per kg, something like that.
Mm-hmm. How it is different? How it is different from energy?
Sir, it is like a specific kind of thing that we call specific heat, like that. If we burn 5 kg of something, then 5 into energy released by 1 kg of that will be the total energy released.
Mm-hmm.
Mass into the calorific value will be the total energy released. Sir, I am entirely not sure about that.
Okay. Achha, any idea about Sriyansh, how we measure the calorific value?
Sir, for hydrocarbons, there is direct formula, H minus something by lower calorific value and higher calorific value, something like that.
I'm asking you how we measure the calorific value. I'm not asking you about the energy. I'm just asking you how we measure the calorific value. Your specialization is in petroleum, na? You mentioned.
No, sir. Chemical engineering.
Chemical engineering. Oh, okay. I think chemical also you faced these type of problems or some content you studied related to this. Yes or no? Studied about this or not?
I don't remember, sir, actually.
You heard about bomb calorimeter?
Yes, sir. I heard.
Kya hota hai?
Sir, actually, में रिवर्सिबल वर्क को इक्वेट करते हैं क्यू के साथ.
रिवर्सिबल वर्क को इक्वेट करते
हैं सर. एक्चुअली
यस
सम कंपोनेंट इज देयर, देयर इज अ इंक्रीज इन एनर्जी दैट क्यू इज इक्वल टू माइनस डब्ल्यू रिवर्सिबल इक्वल टू एमसीपी डेल्टा सी टी समथिंग.
यस वेरी राइट.
यस सर, इट इज समथिंग लाइक दैट.
it is like that only, but you need to correct it. You need to you can refine this particular thing. I think chemical, you know about refining?
Yes, sir.
This is very much impure this time. You need to refine this.
Yes. Sir, actually, it mostly comes in chemistry part. I have read it in 12th class.
Okay. So, what are the subjects? Tell us about your favorite subject.
Sir, you can ask from mass transfer, heat transfer.
Heat transfer, mass transfer. These are your favorite subjects. What about fluid and thermo?
Sir, thermo I can also answer. I can try to at least.
Okay. Okay, let me ask you questions from heat transfer only, heat and mass. So, can you tell us something about the heat exchanger, Shreyans? What is the heat exchanger?
Sir, heat exchanger is a mechanical device used to actually heat or cool a liquid. It can do the both work. Or not only liquid, any fluid. So there are many types. One of them, well, there are mainly two types, recuperative and regenerative. And recuperative also, there are, I think, three types. Indirect contact, direct contact, and one more was there.
What's the difference? What is the difference between recuperative type heat exchanger and regenerative type heat exchanger?
Actually, regenerative types transform its, matlab, sends its energy into a capacitor. And then it transfers it to another fluid. While that recuperative types, it is a direct flow of two, direct exchange of two streams moving at once.
So, क्या mixing हो जाएगा? There will be mixing.
नहीं direct sir, mixing नहीं नहीं होता mixing sir उसमें.
क्या होगा?
तो हम लोग separate करके रखते हैं. So like in shell and tube, हमारा एक tube से जाएगा और एक shell से जाएगा. तो उसमें mixing नहीं होता.
अच्छा effectiveness आपने सुना है श्रेयांश? Effectiveness.
हाँ yes sir.
Can you define this?
Sir, it is a ratio of actual heat transfer divided by maximum heat transfer, and by formula it is given by CPH THI minus TH naught divided by CP min THI minus TCI for co-current heat exchanger.
अच्छा why for maximum heat transfer we are taking minimum heat capacity rate? Why not maximum heat capacity rate? Because if you will multiply maximum temperature difference with maximum heat capacity rate, you will get further more maximum value. What do you think?
Sir, actually it depends on inlet condition, sir. How much it is going. So
what I'm asking you, Shreyansh, the maximum heat transfer, if you want to define, we are defining it with C minimum, heat capacity rate minimum, multiplied by the maximum temperature difference. Why not we are taking maximum heat capacity rate and then the maximum temperature difference? Because maximum heat capacity rate, maximum temperature difference, that will give you the maximum value. What do you think?
Oh, yes, sir. I don't know actually.
Try to think. It's a very common question actually, you know, because if you have studied about effectiveness, I think that question must arise in your mind. Why C minimum? Why not C maximum?
It is, but I never thought actually.
So, can you tell us something about the Grashof number, Shreyansh?
Sir, it is the ratio of buoyancy forces by viscous forces.
Buoyancy forces by viscous forces. Mm-hmm. So buoyancy forces, how you will represent buoyancy forces?
So it is given by G beta T minus T infinity L cube divided by.
That is Grashof number, G beta delta D L cube. I'm just asking you how you will define buoyancy forces.
Sir, buoyancy is actually how much. Yes.
Fluid mechanics somewhere, I think you studied about this buoyancy forces.
Yes, sir.
So, how you will represent buoyancy forces? How you can write a formula for buoyancy forces? Dimensional form, what you can say? I'm giving you a hint. Shreyansh, how you can write the dimensional form of buoyancy force?
Sir, it will be rho Vg only, but it's, I think it is V of solid. Only difference is that.
V of solid, no.
No, V of liquid, sir. That is
always it will be of fluid only.
Yes,
that is the volume of the fluid displaced actually, not.
Yes, sir, that is RPM displaced.
So how you will write its dimensional form? Rho G V of D?
Yes, sir.
Kaise likhoge?
रो वी वी ऑफ फ्लूइड इनटू जी होगा ना।
Can you relate this VFD with the beta value? There is some number, there is some value, beta value. That
सर
you are mentioning in this Grashof number, g beta delta t. What is that beta?
सर इट वाज सम फैक्टर आई फॉरगॉट इट इज गिवन बाय 1 अपॉन टी मतलब 1 अपॉन टेंपरेचर ऑफ द फिल्म
टेंपरेचर ऑफ द फिल्म नहीं दैट दिस इज द 1 ऑफ बाय टी टेंपरेचर ऑफ द फ्लूइड
हां यस सर
दैट इज अ प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ फ्लूइड श्रेयांस
यस सर बट
व्हाट इज दैट व्हाट इज द नेम ऑफ दैट फैक्टर यस दैट इज अ फैक्टर ओनली बट देयर इज अ प्रॉपर्टी व्हाट इज द नेम
आई डोंट रिमेंबर सर
Mathematically, it is represented by some change in volume, Fahrenheit change in temperature at constant pressure, Fahrenheit change in volume. Now, can you think of something about this? Change in volume.
Expansion factor.
Expansion factor. Expansion of what? Expansion of what? That is known as isobaric volume expansion coefficient. Isobaric volume expansion coefficient. You know?
Yes, sir. Actually, I can't recall that.
Achha, what is the role? What is the role of this in what you can say free convection? What is the role of beta in free convection?
Sir, except calculating Grashof number, I don't know actually.
Don't know.
Yes, sir.
Achha, you heard about Scammitt number?
Yes sir.
क्या होता है?
Sir, it is given by mu by rho dAb actually.
Don't
viscous diffusion by mass transfer diffusion.
This is the first interview, Shreyans? Or
yes,
have you appeared for any other MOOC or some kind of interview you have gone? This is your first interview?
Almost sir, of this level it is first. Earlier I gave for one company, Aurobindo Pharma. There I cleared it.
So we are having experts from different domain. What subject you like? We will ask you question from that only. Chance. Just tell us sir, any one single subject which is your favorite one.
Sir, as it is going, you can ask from any. I will try to answer.
Okay. Okay, Nikhil sir, I think we can go ahead with some chemical engineering subjects. I think.
Okay. Thank you, Vishal sir. Okay, Shreyans. Hello.
हाँ जी यस सर.
Can you tell me about your BTech project?
Sir, it was more of a literature review type of project due to pandemic. So, what we did was we collected data on many. Actually, we focused on the plasma treatment of polymeric membranes, and we tried to establish a relation between permeability and contact angle. Permeability, contact angle, and pore radius. Three things. What we found that the permeability is directly proportional to square of the pore radius, and by using one equation that change in the permeability is a function of increase in the pore radius plus surface tension. So what we got is LP is proportional to R square, and another one relation is that LP.
What is permeability?
The permeability is a property of an object to allow something into it.
What is contact angle?
Sir, contact angle, how can I define it? 1 minute, sir. Contact angle is most likely the measure of hydrophobicity and hydrophilicity of membrane as per direct example, and it is measured by one of the method where
angle between what?
Sir, that I can draw it. That surface
it is the angle between two interfaces.
Yes, sir. Actually, but
can you tell me what are the interfaces? There are only two interfaces.
Sir, if this is the that droplet and this is that quad surface, then this angle is known as that contact angle.
Can you show me?
describe this thing? Is it visible?
Where is the angle?
Sir, oh, that angle with that quad is, that quad surface is the contact angle. Actually.
Okay. So, what will be the angle? 180 degrees.
No, sir. It varies according to if the membrane is hydrophilic, then it is.
What is the around, angle for superhydrophobicity?
Sir, it is around. Oh, super hydrophilicity, it will around
super
zero.
Super hydrophobicity.
Oh, that it will be more like more than around 170 to 180. At extreme side, it will be.
Are you sure?
Yes, sir.
And because what about hydrophobicity?
Sir, it is around 15 to 30 degree.
Hydrophobicity only.
Oh, phobicity, sir. Actually, it causes at about 60 degree, then it is that membrane is generally called hydrophobic.
No. It's
not. So,
contact angle should be more than 90 degree for hydrophobicity.
Yes, sir. But we consider that if the surface is hydrophobic, then above 60.
What kind of material you have used for preparation of the membrane?
Sir, actually, it was a literature review project only.
Oh, you have not done anything.
Yes, sir.
Okay. आपने बताया वेस्ट वाटर ट्रीटमेंट में ये यूज हो सकता है ऑयल वाटर से, बताइए इसके बारे में क्या बता रहे थे
सर? एक्चुअली ऑयल वाटर मतलब ऑयली वेस्ट वाटर ट्रीटमेंट में हम लोग इसको यूज कर सकते हैं मेम्ब्रेन को इम्प्रूव करने के लिए, क्योंकि अगर हम लोग प्लाज्मा ट्रीटमेंट करते हैं मेम्ब्रेन का, तो इट विल डायरेक्टली इंक्रीज इट्स परमेबिलिटी एंड हाइड्रोफिलिसिटी, making in directly increasing the flux of the membrane.
Okay, so what do you think, there is only oil and water in wastewater treatment?
No, sir, it is many things, but the first step is the that oil water separation in refinery wastewater treatment.
By using membrane or any other process are there?
Sir, mainly first thing is the is done using filtration only. After that, there were aeration tank, many things are there.
Filtration.
Actually,
can you tell me the different type of method to clean the wastewater treatment? There is one section in IOC for doing for dealing with this wastewater, oily water. You know that?
No, sir.
It is called effluent treatment plant, ETP.
Okay. Yes.
So, do you know what are the various methods we use to clean the, to separate the oil and water and to effluent the water to river side?
Sir, and second is that aeration tank and something trickle bed is also used.
Trickle bed is
not trickle used. Bed, not something. I don't exactly recall, sir.
Okay. Can you hear? Give me overview of petroleum refinery.
So actually, at first, the crude is sent into the desalter unit, and the ions are removed from it, and then it is sent into the preheater.
Ions are removed in the desalter.
Ah, yes, sir.
What kind of ion?
And sir, it is tungsten, salts of sodium, magnesium, and calcium also are removed. And mainly tungsten, nickel, which are poisonous to the catalyst. Okay. And then it is sent into the preheater, preheat train.
Do you know the temperature of the desalter, range of the desalter?
Sir, it is 100 to 110 degree.
Okay.
Then
what,
it is
what preheater? Range of preheater?
Sir, actually, first it is sent into a pre-fractionator at 200 degrees Celsius.
200 degrees Celsius?
Sir, it is pre-fractionator. But then it is heated up to 400 degrees Celsius, then fed it to the crude column. Sir, it is around 350 degrees Celsius. It is sent into the furnace.
You cannot operate at 300 or 400 degrees centigrade at crude distillation, because it will be decomposed. Many products will be decomposed. We cannot get many refinery products. We cannot further process it.
Sir, actually, at 365.
Did you see? Where did you see the temperature? Have you read about it, or are you just saying like that?
No, sir, I read about it. That's why I'm saying.
generally the temperature of defractionator is around 140 degrees.
Sir, then how will be the lower product be separated? Actually, the temperature
you
of...
Tell me. How to separate the residue product?
Sir, not residue actually. That IBP to 140 is naphtha, include distillation column. The gases
IBP
are already
what?
Separated. Huh?
IBP
initial boiling point to 140 degrees Celsius.
Okay.
Then 140 to around 240 is Kiro. 240 to 240 or 270 to 340 is light gas oil. 340 to 365 is heavy gas oil. Then below 365, it is fed into the vacuum column.
Okay.
Where it is again separated by reducing the pressure, which is mainly a application of Clausius-Clapeyron equation. Using the steam jet ejector, we reduce the pressure, and as we reduce the pressure, the boiling point of...
What is the range of pressure in VDE?
Sir, it is very less, 10 to 20 mmHg.
Okay. And what are the major products of VDE? Where did you go?
First is the fuel gases, then light gas oil, then beach spindle oil, then at last it is that heavy vacuum gas oil, then at last vacuum residue.
डायरेक्ट रिफाइनरी प्रोडक्ट देता है आपको या कुछ करना पड़ता है कुछ रिबिल्डिंग प्रोसेस रिफाइनिंग प्रोसेस कुछ है इसमें
सर सबके लिए अलग अलग होता है
क्या क्या
सर फॉर दैट आई विल स्टार्ट विद वैक्यूम रेसिड्यू ओनली सो फ्रॉम वैक्यूम रेसिड्यू वी कैन मेक एक्चुअली वी कैन कन्वर्ट इनटू गैसोलीन आल्सो एंड गैस ऑयल यूजिंग फॉर गैसोलीन वी यूज कॉइल विद ब्रेकिंग एंड फॉर gas oil we use soaker with breaking and we can also convert that vacuum residue to DS faulted oil which is used to make that lubricants
okay.
So that DS faulted
kaise milta hai DS faulted oil
vacuum
residue kaun sa unit mein milta hai
propane DS faulting unit sir
PDS
PDA mein propane
kya hai iska solute kya hai ye kya extraction process hai kya hai ye
extraction process hai सर प्रोपेन डीएस फॉल्टिंग से हम लोग नीचे से एस्फॉल्टिन निकल जाएगा ऊपर से वो आ जाता है डीएस फॉल्ट ऑयल को फिर उसको
हाइड्रोक्रैकर में यूज क्या होता है
सर एस्फॉल्टिंग मेजर से रोड बनाने के लिए काम आता है और ब्यूटीमेन भी बना सकते हैं उससे
और कुछ
ओके सर यही पता है मुझे
ओके व्हाट इज क्रैकिंग प्रोसेस
सर क्रैकिंग इज द रिडक्शन ऑफ लॉन्ग हाइड्रोकार्बन चेन्स इनटू द शॉर्टर वंस बेसिकली इट इज ऑफ टू टाइप्स इन द refinery and one is the FCC cracking and second is the hydro cracking
okay FCC cracking hydro cracking kya difference
sir FCC cracking is more that partial towards the formation of olefins and aromatics while hydro cracking uses a bifunctional metal catalyst with acid site and a metal site which as well as reduces the chain and also saturates the product leading to high cetane number diesel formation and in FCC it is mainly FCC gasoline is the
what
major
are the major product of hydrocracking and FCC
sir hydrocracking it is diesel and FCC is FCC gasoline which is later mixed into the blending pool with other components to form gasoline
okay what is MSQU MSQU
sir it is motor spirit quality upgradation unit So mostly it is used to increase the octane number by involving various reactions such as isomerization.
What are the different solute to increase the octane rating?
Sir?
Different solvent. What are the different solvent to increase the octane rating? You know that?
No sir, I have no idea what solvent.
Is there any chemical which octane number is more than 100?
Sir, it is benzene, I remember 108 and
okay.
2-3. 2-3 dimethyl butane have 104 I guess.
Do you know what is catalyst regeneration is happen inside FCC?
Sorry sir?
Catalyst regeneration.
Yes sir, it is actually catalyst is steadily fed to the there are two slide valves. One is goes to the FCC and then the other sends the catalyst back into the regenerator where it is heated at high temperature, it is between 630 to 720 degrees Celsius. So flue gas is sent out for another electricity, energy generation or other things.
Okay.
So main unit is it removes the coke in the catalyst.
What fluid bed is preferred then a 6-PET during the catalyst regeneration.
In the regenerator, it is bed is there. I thought it is.
That's fluidized bed and 6-PET. Do you know difference between fluidized bed and?
Yes, sir.
So why fluidized bed it is used instead of 6-PET in catalyst regeneration in FCC? क्या फायदा होगा फ्लूडाइज बेड का सोचो उसको बताओ कैटलिस्ट रिजेनरेशन क्या है एक्सोथर्मिक है एंड
उसमें हाई टेंपरेचर एंडोथर्मिक है सर
पक्का
720 डिग्री सेल्सियस पे हो रहा है तो
इसमें दो रहता है रिजेनरेटर होता है रिएक्टर होता है
हाँ रिएक्टर तो सर
एक्सो होता है एंडो होता है
हाँ
दोनों एंडो या दोनों कैटलिस्ट रिजनरेट कर रहे हैं यहाँ पर कोक है यहाँ पर एयर पास कर रहे हैं तो हाईली एक्सोथर्मिक को वहां पर हम लोग टेम्परेचर अप्लाई कर रहे हैं वो एंडोथर्मिक रिएक्ट है
यस
ये कोई प्रॉब्लम ओके व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन मास ट्रांसफर एंड क्विक
सॉरी सर
व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन मास ट्रांसफर एंड फ्लूइड फ्लो
सर फ्लूइड फ्लो इज एक्चुअली Both are actually same thing only, but if we say that fluid flow हो रहा है तो pressure difference उसका driving force होता है और mass transfer का chemical potential होता है.
Okay, दोनों same fluid flow है मतलब mass transfer भी हो रहा है.
Sir, fluid flow है तो mass एक जगह से होके दूसरी जगह जाएगा ही ना.
Yes.
वो fluid sir fluid का खुद का भी mass रहता है ना.
Mass transfer के लिए तुमको क्या लगता है बस एक ही component की जरूरत होता है या दो component एक कंपोनेंट से मास ट्रांसफर हो जाएगा वाटर रेस यहां से यहां फ्लो हो रहा है तो मास ट्रांसफर हो रहा है हैं बताओ
सर मास
ट्रांसफर तो सर सही बोले ड्राइविंग फोर्स सही है ड्राइविंग फोर्स अलग
ड्राइविंग फोर्स मास ट्रांसफर इज एक्चुअली सर ट्रांसफर ऑफ मास फ्रॉम वन पॉइंट टू अनदर पॉइंट तो सर एक में भी हो रहा है तो वो
इट इज नॉट अबाउट मास इट इज अबाउट पर्टिकुलर केमिकल स्पीशीज
हां यस सर
मिक्सचर ऑफ हाइड्रोजन नाइट्रोजन है तो कैसे ऑक्सीजन यहाँ से नाइट्रोजन में जा रहा है नाइट्रोजन ऑक्सीजन में जा रहा है वो मास ट्रांसफर हो रहा है सिर्फ ऑक्सीजन ही है चैम्बर में तो क्या मास ट्रांसफर हो रहा है वो तो डिफरेंस हो रहा है इधर कोई प्रॉब्लम एक एग्जांपल कैन यू गिव मी वन एग्जांपल लिक्विड टू गैस मास ट्रांसफर
लिक्विड टू गैस सर एब्जॉर्प्शन कॉलम में यूज होता है हम लोग H2S को अमोनिया से वो करते हैं अब्सॉर्ब करते हैं
अमोनिया से अब्सॉर्ब करते हैं
सर वो LPG प्योरिफिकेशन के लिए डीएमिनेशन यूनिट रहता है अमाइन ट्रीटमेंट यूनिट सो अमोनिया इज यूज्ड टू अब्सॉर्ब दैट H2S एंड CO2
कैन यू गिव मी वन मोर एग्जांपल फ्रॉम सॉलिड टू लिक्विड मास ट्रांसफर
सॉलिड टू लिक्विड सॉलिड टू लिक्विड एग्जैक्टली तो याद नहीं मुझे सर ड्राइंग भी लगभग वही रहता है
ड्राइंग क्या होता है
पर ड्राइंग में मॉइस्चर रिमूव होता है सर उसमें से
कैसे हुआ सॉलिड से लिक्विड कैसे हुआ उसमें
तो लिक्विड बस इवेपोरेट हुआ पर हां वही भी इवेपोरेशन ही रहता है
उसका मास फ्लक्स का यूनिट क्या है
सॉरी सर
मास फ्लक्स का यूनिट
मोल पर मीटर स्क्वायर सेकंड
मास फ्लक्स का
ओ सॉरी केजी पर मीटर स्क्वायर सेकंड
केजी पर मीटर स्क्वायर सेकंड
यस सर
ओके इसमें एक टर्म रहता है हम लोग एन ए जे ए रहता है डिफरेंस क्या है कहीं पर एन ए यूज होता है कहीं पर जे ए यूज होता है
सर जे ए सर हमारा उससे आता है वो फिक्स डिफ्यूजन लॉ से एन ए हमारा कन्वेक्टिव मास ट्रांसफर रहता है
बस ये डिफरेंस एनए कन्वेक्टिव है जे दोनों इक्वल का होता है एनए और जे
सर इंटरफेस बाउंड्री पे शायद इक्वल रहते थे वो लोग
ओके ठीक है थैंक यू सर
ओके सो आई थिंक वी गिव द फीडबैक नाउ टू हिम सो श्रेयांश लेट मी गिव यू द फीडबैक ऑफ एचआर पार्ट
Yes, sir.
I found your introduction to be very superficial and long. आपको अपने बहुत ही precise introduction देनी है. Otherwise, if you give your introduction in the form of a passage, then you cannot pull interview in your direction. The purpose of introduction is that you say something due to which you are in position to pull interview in particular direction.
Yes.
Say anything, but interview should be in that direction then. Next question you should predict. Lekin aapne itni jyada information de di ke you don't know what they are going to ask you after that. You are adding strengths, weaknesses, everything in the introduction. Introduction should be very precise, very, very brief. That sir, I am Shreyansh for this part of India, and sir, I am still in graduation, pursuing my chemical engineering, and I think it is a campus placement. You need not to even mention that.
Yes, sir.
You say, sir, I am Shreyansh and I belong to this part of India, and presently my CGPA going on is this much. You need not to tell about the college or final year because that is understood. So this is my CGPA, and I am working on a project, sir, which is this. And I would like to join HPCL, IUCL, because this is one of the most prestigious job I can afford being in campus. Because public sector are the best employers, sir. They give you best salary, they give you best career, they give you very good prestigious profile. So I would like to join this prestigious organization, sir. Yahan pe baat chodo, apni. Let them ask further, whatever they ask. Right? तो उसको देखो और IUCL का थोड़ा सा इंफॉर्मेशन गैदर करो, सी हाउ दे आर डिफरेंट फ्रॉम अदर्स, एंड IUCL का वेबसाइट जरूर विजिट करो, हु इज द CMD एंड ऑल दीस थिंग्स, वो विजिट करो बिकॉज़ दैट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, राइट? और उसके ऊपर थोड़ा सा वर्कआउट करो, और बहुत से वीडियो पड़े हुए हैं पैनल के ऊपर, प्योर पीडीए के ऊपर, उसमें वेबसाइट पे पड़े हुए हैं, उनको सुनो, IUCL वगैरह के बहुत से इंटरव्यू लिए हुए हैं श्रेयस, उनको थोड़ा सुनो, क्या क्वेश्चन पूछे जा सकते हैं, प्रोबेबल क्वेश्चंस आप में ऐसा क्या है, हाउ यू आर डिफरेंट फ्रॉम अदर स्टूडेंट्स इन योर क्लास. यू कैन नॉट से सर आई एम डिफरेंट फ्रॉम अदर्स बिकॉज आई एम डिसिप्लिन्ड और आई हैव मोर मार्क्स और आई हैव मोर नॉलेज, टेक्निकल नॉलेज मेरी ज्यादा है, दैट इज नॉट द आंसर. दे आर आस्किंग यू हाउ यू आर डिफरेंट इन सॉफ्ट स्किल्स. तो यू विल से सर आई थिंक इन एम्प्लॉय देर आर सर्टन पर्सनैलिटी ट्रेड्स रिक्वायर्ड. He should be disciplined, he should be honest, he should be sincere, he should be committed. So I rate myself above average in all these traits. And there's a reason, sir, I think I deserve this job. Right? This is how you have to justify your answer. Anything related to HR part you want to ask me?
No, sir, I will work on it.
Yes, please go for this. Fine?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. Yeah, Vishal sir.
Yes, Nikhil sir.
Okay. Okay, students, आपको आप बहुत हेजिटेट कर रहे हैं, आपको नहीं आ रहा, आप गेस मार रहे हैं, वो मत करिए आप, ठीक है? नहीं आ रहा कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं, आप बोल सकते हैं नहीं आ रहा, क्योंकि ऐसा बहुत सारा क्वेश्चन है वो पूछ सकते हैं आप, ठीक है?
जी सर.
आपका इंटरव्यू कब है
सर? 26
को. ठीक है, तो आप ज्यादा से ज्यादा जितना एब्जॉर्ब कर सकते हैं IUCL के बारे में आपको जानना है, ठीक है? क्या क्या प्रोडक्ट्स वो बना रहा है, मार्केट में किस नाम से उसका प्रोडक्ट है, ठीक है? कहाँ कहाँ रिफाइनरी है, क्या क्या लोकेशंस में IUCL है, ये सब आपको जानना होगा. आप कहाँ रहते हैं, उसके आसपास में IUCL का क्या है, वो आपको जानना होगा, ठीक है? और जो आप केमिकल इंजीनियरिंग में पढ़ रहे हैं, जैसे मास ट्रांसफर आपने बोला आपका फेवरेट सब्जेक्ट है, तो मास ट्रांसफर कहाँ कहाँ यूज हो रहा है, क्योंकि पूरा मास ट्रांसफर वेस्ट है ये रिफाइनरी आपका. एक्सट्रैक्शन कहाँ पर यूज हो रहा है, एब्जॉर्प्शन कहाँ पर यूज हो रहा है, ठीक है? आपका डिस्टिलेशन कैसे यूज हो रहा है, ये आपको जानना है. और जो चार पांच यूनिट है, जैसे FCC हो गया, हाइड्रो क्रैकर हो गया, ठीक है, CDU हो गया, VDU हो गया, ये आपको जानना है, उसका बेसिक जानना है, उसका बेसिक प्रोडक्ट क्या है, उसका फीड स्टॉक क्या है. इतना आप चीज बोल देंगे तो इतना में हो जाएगा आपका काम, ठीक है? और एक्स्ट्रा आप कर सकते हैं जो कि उसका फिजिकल प्रॉपर्टीज होता है, क्रूड ऑयल का हो गया, ठीक है? क्या क्या प्रॉपर्टीज होता है उसमें, मतलब कैसे उसको डिफाइन करते हैं क्रूड ऑयल को, हाई लो सल्फर बेस्ट में या हाई सल्फर बेस्ट में, ये आपको जानना है, ठीक है? उसके बाद आपको क्रैकिंग क्या होता है, रिफॉर्मिंग क्या होता है, हाइड्रो ट्रीटिंग क्या होता है, ये सब आपको जानना है. बाकी आप एक दो अपना फेवरेट सब्जेक्ट बनाए रहिए, बाकी ये सब आपको IUCL के बारे में मैक्सिमम एब्जॉर्ब करना है आपको, बाकी कोई दिक्कत नहीं.
जी सर.
ओके ओके सर, आई एम डन फ्रॉम माय साइड.
हां, यस यस निखिल सर, थैंक यू. So Shreyansh, I asked some questions from heat transfer. First, I asked you about energy. So, Shreyansh, what I feel in an interview, it is not required to answer all the questions. But what is required? Proper defending of those particular questions, effective delivery, that is required. Okay. And yes, what I feel ki in this interview, you have not defended those questions. Okay, so you can improve that. Okay, even if you don't know, you need to answer, you need to try to defend that your approach matters actually. Yes. At least you need to try. Okay, like I asked you about energy, you have not answered, like even you have not got any idea about energy. So you can define energy. Although I know, like everybody knows, it is very difficult to actually define energy. Okay, we are not having any standard definition of energy, but you can try to define at least. You can say, sir, it is a ability to do work. It is a thing which keeps us active. It is a thing which makes us capable to do something. Okay, there are so many ways.
Yes, sir.
But one thing you need to very clearly define, sir, calorific values are energy which lies at the atomic level. So energy can have different forms, the kinetic energy, the potential energy, the nuclear energy, vibrational energy, yes, rotational energy. So only the energy which lies at the molecule, because a chemical reaction, the combustion is a kind of chemical reaction only. It is a very complex chemical reaction, but it's a kind of chemical reaction only. Are you getting? And yes, in chemical reaction, what kind of energy we are using? That is a kind of atomic energy only, because atoms are participating in that particular chemical reactions, not your nucleons. Okay,
yes,
nuclear reaction mein nucleons aa jayenge. So that you need to mention ki sir, kinetic energy, potential energy, these are different forms of energy. Out of those energy, which the energy which lies at the atomic level, that energy is known as a calorific value. It is actually a measure of the energy which we can liberate from the complete combustion of a unit mass of a substance under ideal standard conditions. So bomb calorimeter is a device with which we measure this calorific value. To aapko pata hona chahiye calorific value kya hota hai, kaise hum इंजीनियरिंग में आपने नहीं पढ़ा होगा, बट मैकेनिकल में आता है ग्रेशोफ नंबर. अगेन यू आंसर्ड द इनर्शिया ऑफ बायोंसी फोर्स बाय विस्कस फोर्सेस, बट यू हैव नॉट आंसर्ड अबाउट बीटा वैल्यू, आइसोबारिक वॉल्यूम एक्सपेंशन कोफिशिएंट, दैट इज नोन एज आइसोबारिक. देन 1 बाय डी बीटा इक्वल टू 1 बाय डी फॉर आइडियल गैस. बट सपोज इफ दे विल आस्क यू, कैन यू प्रूव, कैन यू शो अस लाइक व्हाई इट इज इक्वल टू 1 बाय डी फॉर आइडियल गैस? आई डोंट थिंक यू विल बी एबल टू एक्चुअली प्रूव दैट.
यस सर.
So you need to be very clear about these things. And even if they will ask you to derive that Grashof number, you will not able to derive just by knowing the ratio of the buoyancy force or viscous force. Because if you don't know how to write the dimensional form of buoyancy force, are you ready? Actually, you need to, for Grashof number, you need to write it like this: inertia force into buoyancy force by square of viscous forces. And then if you will write the dimensional form of inertia force, dimensional form of buoyancy force, and then square of the viscous forces, then you will get that particular Grashof number g beta delta t by g beta delta t l cube by nu square.
Yes, sir.
But wo har term aapko pata hona chahiye. I asked you about Scammon number, and again you answered in some mathematical way. You know, to answer, sir, it is a ratio of the momentum diffusivity to the mass diffusivity, sir. Okay. And this number, like the Prandtl number, sir, Prandtl number relates the hydrodynamic boundary layer thickness with the thermal boundary layer thickness. Okay, and this mass Scammon number, sir, this is actually introduced in the mass transfer, and this number, sir, like the Prandtl number, relates the hydrodynamic boundary layer thickness with the mass boundary layer thickness. Mass boundary.
Yes, layer yes, thickness. Sir, yes, sir.
तो आपको उस तरह से बताना है थोड़ा सा, ठीक है?
Yes, sir.
थोड़ा सा अभी मेरे को वो कमी लगी इसमें, श्रेयांश. I think आपने भी इसको feel किया होगा, and you need to improve that technical content, technical knowledge also, and your way of delivery also. एंड एटलीस्ट आपको डिफेंड जरूर करना है, अप्रोच जरूर आपको हेल्दी रखना है, हथियार नहीं डाल देने कि चलो सर मेरे को तो आता नहीं है, ठीक है? तो एटलीस्ट उसको अच्छे से हैंडल करना है, ठीक है श्रेयांश?
जी सर.
ओके, गुड लक श्रेयांश. व्हेन इज योर इंटरव्यू?
सर 18th और
26th को.
जी सर.
हाँ, तो अभी दो तीन दिन है, अच्छे से एफर्ट्स लगाओ, ट्राई टू गेट. एक हीट एक्सचेंजर का क्यों आंसर क्वेश्चन मैंने आपसे पूछा था, मैं उसको भी आंसर कर देता हूँ. व्हाई वी टेक सी मिनिमम, व्हाई नॉट सी मैक्सिमम? Because for the C maximum, if you are taking, for the C maximum, suppose you are assuming the temperature change THI minus THI, TCI, that is the maximum temperature change. and sir. That maximum heat capacity rate. So for the maximum heat capacity rate fluid, if you are assuming the maximum temperature change THI minus TCI, so what will be the temperature change for minimum heat capacity fluid? That will be more than THI minus TCI. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
For a minimum heat capacity fluid, for a maximum heat capacity fluid, if the temperature changes THI minus TCI, for a minimum heat capacity fluid, the temperature change will be more than that. Mm-hmm. Are you getting?
Yes,
but
sir.
That temperature is not possible, because temperature change more than THI minus TCI is impossible.
Yes,
maximum temperature difference THI minus TCI. Okay. And that is possible. Maximum temperature change is possible with what? Minimum heat capacity rate. You know, equation, energy balance equation of heat exchanger. Heat capacity rate, C of hot fluid, TH into delta
yes,
T of the hot fluid,
C MC hot fluid to delta, delta T.
T to high. तभी तो आपको temperature difference ज़्यादा मिलेगा.
Yes, sir.
Are you getting?
Yes, sir.
ठीक है. उसको आंसर करना है, रिलेट करना है. चलिए ठीक है, तो थोड़ा मेहनत करो श्रीराज, एंड यू आर हैविंग टाइम 2-3 डेज, प्लीज रिवाइज ऑल दिस सब्जेक्ट्स, फ्लूइड एंड दिस सॉरी आईओ जो अपना आईसी इंजन के कुछ फ्यूल वाला पार्ट है, दैट फ्यूल पार्ट यू नीड टू रिवाइज.
सर वो मैं पढ़ के आया था.
चलिए कोई बात नहीं, होता है अभी, कोई बात नहीं. एंड इफ यू विल वर्क हार्ड, यू विल प्रैक्टिस, श्योरली यू विल बी एबल टू इंप्रूव योरसेल्फ एंड यू विल बी एबल टू डिलीवर वेल इन योर फाइनल इंटरव्यू. तो गुड लक, शेयर्स, कीप प्रिपेयरिंग.